I'm John White. With me today is Dee McLaughlin, and Dee is one of our master gardeners here in Doniana County, and Dee has brought some samples to talk about.
John, I've got this rubber plant at my house, and all the leaves are falling off. Some of them are green and falling off, and some of them are this golden color. What's the problem here?
Okay. I think with the browning along the center rib on this one, there might be a drainage problem in the pot. A lot of times indoor plants, people set them inside a saucer, and then when they water, the water goes through the plant and then collects in the saucer, but the pot's sitting in the saucer, so it's sucking the water back up into it. So it stays wet for long periods of time. So on this one, I would probably look and see whether it might be staying overly wet, and that would cause some of the problems like this with the browning along the rib. If it was lack of water, you would get some leaf drop, but you would get some browning along the edges of the leaf. But my guess would be probably a poor drainage situation.
Okay. John, my neighbor brought me this pomegranate from their bush, and it's the fruit's all misshapen, and there's this funny little white dots on the back of the leaves. Do you have any suggestions?
Okay. The pomegranate here just looks like a mummified pomegranate. And, you know, for some reason this particular fruit didn't develop. Could even be left over from last year's. Does need to be pulled off and just discarded. You didn't mention whether the plant had any new blooms or any fruit produced on it. Some of the little insects that are on the backside here look like they might be some immature, possibly a white fly, that is a little cluster here starting on the underside. I don't see too much on the others, so it's just that one leaf there that could be pulled off and just thrown away that way. But any of the blackened mummified fruit, they just need to be pulled off, and they could have been left on. So I don't see anything real troublesome there.
Thank you. I've got these very unhappy petunias here today. This one seems to have a worm. The leaves are all sticky, and there's lots of holes on here. Is there any hope for these plants?
Well, there's some hope. They do look a little rough right now. The worm that's in here is, of course, what's causing the holes in the leaf. Looks like a little army worm that has gotten in there. And that can be treated with an insecticide. There are several insecticides that can be used on that. Some of the stickiness feels like possibly some aphid or maybe some mite damage on it. Don't see the aphids right now, but there is quite sticky, so there's some kind of sucking insect that's been on it. And again, that can be taken care of with insecticide. So once you get the insects under control, then the petunia will continue to put on new growth. And of course, what's damaged just gonna have to stay on, but it'll put out new growth. And you can pinch some of the ends and cause it to put out some new growth down a little further to maybe thicken out some of the damaged area so it hides some of the damage.
Is there one insecticide that'll help with both of these problems?
Right, there is. And again, you want to use an approved insecticide that can be used on petunias, and also take care of aphids and some of our lepidopterous type insects, the caterpillars.
My neighbor has this peach tree with these tiny little peaches, and this one, strange color to it.
Okay.
What should we do about that?
Okay, for one thing, this peach has too many peaches on it. These really need to be thinned out. I usually like to space them somewhere around 6 to 8 inches between fruit. So those need to be pulled off. And
the reason, pull them off at this point or earlier?
It should have been done earlier, but you can still do it at this point. What it does is help the peaches that are left to size more, and they'll usually have more flavor and much better color, so they'll be a lot nicer. Now, this particular peach here looks like it's had a lot of scarring on the skin of it, so it may have had an insect maybe feeding on the outer skin of the fruit when it was trying to develop, and has damaged that, so it almost has like a scarring effect on it. So that one probably just needs to be pulled because it won't develop well. So go ahead and get those off. But the color of the leaves look pretty good, but just way too much fruit for one small branch.
There's a few little holes on this. Is this something to worry about?
Okay, the holes are called shot hole virus. They're pretty common on Prunus, members of the Prunus genus, and they're just with it. You really don't need to spray or anything, so you just go ahead and let those go. It's not insect related, so it just has too big a crop. So thank you for bringing the samples, and thank you for being on this portion of Southwest Yard and Garden.
Thank you for all your good advice.
We'll be right back.